and as the thoughts of the massacre of what is known as the Black Plague washed over his mind like a cool breeze, he looked upon his people and said, Game Grumps are going to be doing an AMA on the Reddit AMA subreddit at 3 p.m.
Sorry for kicking the camera, guys.
It's okay. It's perfect.
That might be perfect,
actually. Hey. Uh-oh, Buster acts. Uh-oh, Buster asks.
Yes.
Who farts more in the Grump room?
Aaron.
Me.
Definitely.
I fart all the
definitely
time.
Definitely Aaron.
I burp, too.
It's disgusting.
It's revolting.
Sometimes your burps are worse than your farts.
Oh, they're always worse, actually. My farts are actually quite pleasant.
They're not.
To me.
Thank you for asking.
Yes. Cha-Cha Jenkins asks if we ever... What? You got a problem with that name?
No.
Cha-Cha Jenkins.
Thank you, Cha-Cha.
If I weren't Eager Raptor already, I'd take your name.
Yeah.
I'd sell it on the black market.
Yeah. Thank you, Mr. or Mrs. Jenkins.
Is Cha your first name?
Yeah, and Cha is your, also your middle name.
Yeah, yeah. Cha-Cha Jenkins. Anyway, Cha-Cha Jenkins, he or she asks, do you guys ever get burned out when recording?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Every week.
After every recording. It's strange how taxing it is.
Yeah, because it takes a lot of focus, because on one hand, we're trying to play the game decently, contrary to popular belief, but also trying to be entertaining at the same time. And, like, weirdly, after, like, you know, 5 or 6 hours of that, you do find yourself exhausted.
Here's a little test.
Yeah.
Turn on a video game. Turn on a microphone. See how everything changes.
Yeah.
Because you think you're being super funny with your friends, right? And then when you're recording and there's that pressure, you're like, Sundays are my favorite day. Like, there's nowhere to go.
That's
so
totally true.
You have to stay focused, and by the end of the day, it's just like, do you want a tea or something?
That's also why we play like less taxing games at like 2 a.m, like when we're really tired, like Kirby's Epic Yarn, stuff that makes us like super happy. And we're like, oh, the colors.
Oh, I'm happy right now, just thinking about it.
Yeah, me too.
Can we just think about Kirby's Epic Yarn for like a couple minutes?
Okay.
Alright. Zappanail asks, inevitable Sonic 06 question.
Oh yeah, all capitals.
Yeah.
Way to drive it home.
So the question is, will we be finishing Sonic 06?
Right.
The answer is no. It just wouldn't feel right.
Yeah, no.
I don't want to subject Dan to that. Craziness.
It's very well. I did watch the episodes,
oh, really?
So yeah. I know the horror. But yeah, no, it wouldn't feel right. I wasn't there for the journey.
Plus,
so.
there's not much left in the game.
Yeah,
it's kind of already been said, which is this game is bad.
Yeah.
Like I don't know how many more ways you can say it. It's just like this game sucks. This game's bad. Oh look at that. That sucks. I don't know. There's nowhere to go at that point.
Yeah, I think so. I think we'll let that one lie.
So this one's from Love Otter.
Love Otter.
Yeah. What was it like getting all the backlash from when you first got on the show?
Well, I've been putting out videos with Ninja Sex Party for years, and I had also been a host on another show for Mondo at one point. So I was so used to internet hate that it didn't even faze me.
It's pretty overwhelming, though.
Yeah. But when you first asked me to be on the show, just knowing how the internet feels about change. I think I said to you, I was like, I'm going to be the most hated person on the internet.
And then
for...
I was like, yeah.
Yeah. You're like, yeah, you will. But you also said, just relax and be yourself, and it'll blow over in like 2 weeks. And it blew over, I think, in like 10 days.
Oh, yeah.
So it was like...
It was Mayor Luigi that won everyone over.
Mayor Luigi. That won myself over. I thought I sucked until that moment.
Yeah, I think that was the moment where I was like, I think this is going to work out.
Yeah. So it was, someone told me I should die in a barn fire. Did I ever tell you about that?
Well, that's true.
Yeah, I mean, I should. But it really wasn't as bad as I thought it would be, and the love I got from people was much more overwhelming than the hate. So it was really cool.
I love this guy. So I said I love the sky.
Oh, okay.
I don't know about you. You should die in a barn.
Alex Steven 6 asks, how is Game Grumps compared to what you thought it would be? I guess referring to like when I started it. I honestly don't know, because it was for fun, Like, it was just a stupid...
Yeah.
Like, those were worth old playing video games. This will be great. And then, you know, when the first 100,000 subs showed up in, like, 2 days, it was like, oh. I guess this is a thing now. Mm. I honestly didn't expect it to be, like, a full-time thing. It was kind of a side project. And it grew into, like, this big... And now it's bigger than Egoraptor now, almost.
Yeah.
And so, I guess... I didn't expect it to be this thing that brought all of my friends together, because it was just this dumb side project and we all had our own things going on, and then like I brought everyone else in and it was like, it was really cool to have like this kind of community and we have a situation.
Yeah, it is cool. And for me, like I didn't expect it to be like two things, because when we're recording the show and it's just you and me on the couch, it's one thing. It's like laughing with your buddy. And then once it's up there and you get the responses from everybody else, then it's something else. Then it's like a huge, huge amount of people and a shared experience. So that's kind of cool, because I like both, you know?
I only like the fan stuff. Sitting on the couch with this dummy,
I know,
sucks.
Kind of a chore.
I'm just kidding, it's great.
Skittles?
That's so nice.
Yeah. Purple. Oh, I love the purple ones. No.
Is that the new green?
It is. Is it gross?
No, it's the old green. Oh, it is the new green.
Jay Redknot asks, what's your favorite food to eat while grumping? Dan?
It's close. No, I love Skittles.
See, I didn't know
mm-hmm.
until you sat down for the first steam train, and you were like, do you have Skittles? Oh my god! And I was like, why? Do you like Skittles? And you were like, please! Yeah.
Only as much as I like love and approval from my parents.
At least you can have unlimited Skittles.
Yeah. No, it's the best. I love Skittles and Pepsi, and washing down Skittles with Pepsi. And I look forward to living well into my 40s.
Well into my tomorrows.
Yeah. I just love the taste, man.
My favorite food, well, there's no face cam on our video, so you can't see the situation that I have going on, but every time we do Grumps, I have a 5-course filet mignon.
That is.
Followed up with a beef Wellington, followed up with steak tartare, followed up with a T-bone steak.
Yep.
And finished up with a ribeye steak.
Yeah. So. And then he just eats a live cow that we walk through the room.
Well, that's just dessert.
Yeah.
I don't think that was worth mentioning.
Wash it down with a cow.
Just, that's gross. I'm sorry.
No.
Just right in the udders.
That is gross.
I get some like ice in my mouth, and then I go to, I'm like, ah, make it fresh. It's as fresh as you can get it.
I think we can cut this one, Steve.
No. A little bit of sugar. Pack NB has three good questions.
Oh.
The first one is, what's my favorite Mega Man track? And he said, if it's not Galaxy Man's, you're dead. Galaxy Man's very good.
Yeah.
I'm a fan of Jewel Man. Oh. I'm a fan of Nitro Man. I'm a fan of Crystal Man, Gyro Man. Just a fan
just
of them all.
Just a fan.
I just really like all the music in Mega Man.
I like Galaxy Man the most.
Really?
You nailed it.
Nice pandering. I like it. This other question is also for me, so go. You can just go off. All right.
Drink,
yeah. Why don't you drink for me? I don't drink because I don't... You okay over there?
Yeah, I'm fine. Go ahead.
You want a drink?
No, I'm f***ing off like you asked me to.
Sweet. Well, I don't drink because I had this... Well, first of all, I don't...
Just gonna see what's over here real quick.
Yeah, okay. need a tissue?
No, I'm fine.
Okay. You want a wet nap?
No, go ahead. You finish your thing.
All right. I don't drink because... Do you want a hug?
No, I'm fine. Good.
I just wanted you to f*** off for that, for this. You can come back afterwards.
No, I'm in my happy place. Go ahead.
I don't drink because this stuff happens. Okay. That's why.
DrainBamage16 asks, how many Skittles and pretzels are consumed in an average episode?
Probably the whole bag.
Yeah, all the Skittles.
Like, you know how they come in different tiers? Like, there's that one. It starts with that one.
Yeah, these tiny little.
And then it goes up to, like, the 17-pound bag.
Yeah.
That one.
Well, Aaron has a giant box of Skittles that
That's right, yeah.
That was a gift from...
Nathan Barnett.
Yeah, who is just a swell dude. And I went over to his house one time and he showed it to me and I was like,
yeah. Plus, we have an entire backstock of the lime Skittles.
That's why for so long people wanted to know if I liked the green apple Skittles. I don't. But like, I didn't know what the answer was because like...
You've just been eating those.
Yeah. The old ones from the box. And like, they're just like... It's like pasta, you know? Like, you just keep eating it. And yet, like, after you've eaten 1,000 of them, there's like more than there ever was before when you started. Mm-hmm. It's, yeah. So... A lot of Skittles and a lot of pretzels.
Yeah. And in terms of what pretzels, I'm down for the thins. Original thins, man, those are the bomb.
I like the rods.
Mini thins, the rods.
Mm-hmm.
Come on, man.
You gave me the rods.
They get all stuck together. There's like five in a row like this, like a pan flute pretzel. You can't, it's gross. It's like, and it's all hard and brittle.
I'm just imagining like, come children.
Come children. Raslin asks, any new guest Grumps? Yes. Yes, there will be more guest Grumps. We've been planning and gathering a backstock of celebrities, kind of, sort of.
That's true. We need a new couch.
Yeah, that's the biggest issue. We have this tiny couch, and when Grant was on the show, it was kind of squished, and we felt really weird. Grant's cool. And he was really cool about it, but it was like, if we got somebody who was just kind of like in and out, like, this game, bro.
I'm Hollywood Mirror.
It would kind of be like, what is this BS?
There's that weird stain on the left side of the couch, too.
Oh, that's true.
Yeah, I don't know what
it
is.
The white stain.
It's very suspect.
So we make them sit on that.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
Scorch Razorick asks... Yeah, it's a sweet name.
I love it.
I actually wrote it as a scrotch when I first wrote it.
That's unfortunate.
I'm partly dyslexic, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
I misspelled you look nice on the actual topic.
Oh, you like nice?
Yeah, I like you like nice, and I can't change it. So
you like nice scratch.
That's great. Anyway, Scratch Razorick asks, we all love Ross, but do you ever just feel like punching him? Yes.
Oh my God.
For his excessive backseat gaming. And yes. Any opportunity is a good opportunity to punch Ross.
Mm-hmm. We always have to qualify it by saying that Ross is like one of our most beloved friends that we care about.
It's funny how it's always, if he's not present, we're just like, oh, that guy.
Yeah.
But he's so sweet. Like, we love Ross.
We love him so dearly.
But gosh, dang it, I wish I could punch him in the nuts.
I've never loved anyone who's so infuriating in so many, like, totally. Different situations.
I don't know if it's come through enough in the show yet, but in reality, it's not the backseat gaming that merits the punch in the face.
Yeah.
It's the throwing the game.
Yeah.
And making it completely unbalanced for everyone else.
He does that. He does that.
When he knows he's going to lose, he decides to take matters into his own hands.
Yeah.
Of who's going to win now. That gives him the power that he craves.
Yeah, it's true. But we haven't established that on the show enough. So we look like jerks when we're coming down on him.
Oh, yeah.
But
because we know it's coming.
Yeah, exactly.
We know if he starts to lose, he's going to be like, and like take an hour for a turn. And
oh, no. I'm Ross. Kangaroos. Yeah.
We assure you that he is the dick.
Dragon Enforcer, who enforces
dragons.
All dragon law.
All of them.
He's also a remixer, so thank you for that.
Whoa, that's awesome.
Yeah, I know. We love remixers. He asks, what was the decision process for making Dan not so grown? Well,
no, I don't know. I don't know what it was.
He locked me in a dungeon and wouldn't feed me unless I... it was very easy for me because Dan has excessive improv experience. Off camera, we're pretty much how we are on camera. And I think the moment where I realized it was going to work out was when we were... This is kind of underground.
Oh, right? Yeah, go ahead.
When we were discussing an album
and
titles for the album, we were just cracking each other up so hard. And I was like, you know what? I think, like, it wasn't planned then at the time.
Right.
But I was like, man, this we really have, like, a thing. We have, like, a chemistry. And it would work out on Game Grumps. So, like, I thought back to that, and I was like, this is going to happen.
Yeah, and for my part, like, when Aaron asked me to join the show, I was like, yeah. There was, like, no hesitation, because I knew it would be awesome. And that's about it.
Dr. K. Nathan asks.
Go on.
That is not. You need to read better.
Sorry.
What was it like hitting record that very first time on Game Grumps? Mostly.
Oh, for me.
Yeah.
That was Punch Out.
Yeah, it was.
That was.
I'm actually curious about this because I don't even know.
It was fun. It was exciting.
What was going through your mind, man?
A lot of things, honestly.
Like, what did you think was going to happen, and like, compared to how it was?
You know what? I didn't think too much because, like, the main rule of improv comedy is don't think.
Yeah.
You know, like, because when you think, like, your mind seizes up, and you're like, So I was like, I'll just focus on playing Punch Out. You know, which is something I can do, and then and let the rest fall into place. And then, like, I mean, it was easy because Aaron and I have been friends for years now, and it's just hanging out and playing video games and being an idiot with your buddy. So that part was easy. I think it was actually a later episode when I realized what it's like to be on the show and the response it gets and just how many people are watching. So I think it was the second recording session that we did that, like, we started playing, and I was like, I hope I don't disappoint a million people.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Once you start reading the comments.
Yeah, oh, yeah, sure.
Can't do that. Can't read the comments.
But even the comments started switching after that. So, and now it's just super, I look forward to it every week because it's fun and it's easy and it's cool and it's enjoyable, and that's it.
You know what's interesting for me is when Dan and I first started recording, even though I was like the like experienced one, like I'd already been doing it for a year, Dan's such a powerhouse when it comes to like comedy and improv comedy.
Stop.
I was like, oh no, he's gonna, ooh, this is gonna be great. I'm gonna be the lesser one now. Like he's so good.
That's
so. I was a little nervous actually.
That's very sweet.
But then it became amazing.
Yeah. No, it's super good.
Pretty quickly.
Yeah. I would say by the third recording session that we did, it's just been that feeling throughout, you know, to where we are now. It just became what it was really quickly.
Cavix, C-A-V-X, asks, during some episodes, you seem to be very well aware of some outspoken criticism regarding listening to the instructions and understanding how to play certain games properly.
Yeah.
Obviously, this criticism comes with the format to some degree, but it also seems lately that you've been playing the games a bit off camera before recording. That's true. And reading manuals and playing strategy guides for your playthrough. Is it safe to say that you're trying to alleviate that complaint? Yes. We are definitely trying to do that a little bit better. The problem is, it's just the way we do things. Like, we're improv comedians first, and game players second. Like, when we play games on our own, see, when you're playing a game at home and you're focused on what's going on and you can do this thing and put things together. But when you're talking about your farts,
yeah,
and burps, there's a little bit more going on in your brain.
Yeah, I think we're basically just trying to make it an entertaining show, and like, some of the people, because different people watch the show for different reasons, you know, we know that, like, we hear that a lot, like, some people watch it because they like the gameplay, some people watch it because they like us, and you want to find the balance, you know, like, for the people who love the gameplay, like, we can do an episode of us just, like, sucking at a game and laughing and thinking, like, wow, that was so great, but someone watches it and they're like, oh, you're horrible!
Yeah.
So we want to make it a better show for them, and that's pretty much all we're trying to do.
Definitely. And there's a follow-up question to that from the same guy. Do you feel this kind of thing contradicts your points in Sequelitis? No, because it's circumstantially different. Like, even really intuitive game design, when you're in that mode, it gets lost on you sometimes, like you don't pay as much attention, like particularly with like the blooper battle.
Oh yeah, and yeah.
When people were like, oh, you can pull the things
so
out.
Stupid, like, you're so stupid.
I didn't make that connection of like pulling the thing out at the very beginning, and just because I was talking about, I don't remember what I was talking about, dogs.
Right.
Dog bones.
Something like that.
Yeah, so. Yes and no. Was that?
Also,
huh?
Yes.
Oh, okay, yeah, what?
Kubitoast asks, Danny and Ego, as an aspiring stand-up comic/musical comedian. What are some times and recommended paths to take on my journeys?
Sometimes?
I don't know if that's what he meant.
Yeah.
But he's basically asking for advice.
Yeah. For being a stand-up comic and musical comedian.
Go for it.
Well, you got the musical comedian thing down.
The best advice I ever got was from this improv teacher I had named Gary Austin. He was the one who taught me the f***ing adjustment.
Oh,
yeah,
nice.
Yeah, which very we've nice. Mentioned on the show. We're gonna have to bleep that out. Sorry. he basically used this Willie Nelson quote, which was, "Do your work, and the world will beat a path to your door," and nothing could be truer. You just.
I never heard that one.
Yeah, you just start working. Work as hard as you possibly can on it with all of your free time, and you just get better and better, and then. If you like, it sounds pretentious to say it, but if you work on your craft, good things happen. Because when I started Ninja Sex Party, I had no idea it would lead me to this, but that's how Aaron and I met, because you saw those videos. Mm-hmm. So you just do stuff and you work hard, even if you can't see, like don't worry about fame, don't worry about like popularity. That none of that matters at the beginning. All that matters is doing something good. And the rest comes naturally.
The biggest thing is that, like, as an artist, because if you do anything creative, you're an artist. Like, it's not a pretentious term. As an artist, when you create something, it should be something that you want to create. Because, like, you know, when you're done performing and you go home and you have to live with yourself, you're gonna hate yourself if you pander or do something like, you know, really stupid or something that you don't find funny. Or whatever. So just like stick to what you know, and that will A, make you a more sane person, and B, make your work more unique. Because like sticking to trends and stuff like that is good in the short term sometimes, but how is it gonna set you apart from other people? Like, how are you gonna develop a voice if you do that?
Yeah, there's always gonna be someone more famous than you. You know? Yeah. Like,
and it's always gonna infuriate you because they do all the things that you think you should be doing.
Yeah. And as for the person who's the most famous person in the world, it usually drives them crazy.
Yeah.
So like don't make fame your goal. Just make your goal like doing what you do to the best of your ability, and that's something that no one else can take away from you because that's your unique comic voice, as they say.
Yep. Unwright asks, he is a aspiring singer. He's taking singing lessons.
Good for you.
And he wants to know, well, I guess it could be a she. Unwright isn't exactly a...
Yeah, no.
Anyway. they're learning how to sing, and they wanted to know what our warm-ups for our voice acting and singing are.
The best advice I would say is go online and find a vocal instructor.
Yeah.
Check out their website. Find the testimonials section. That's what you want to look at. You want to look at a lot of like different people saying like this person knows what they're talking about,
yeah.
Because there's plenty of voice teachers out there, and not all of them are good. So find one that looks good. Go in, give it a shot. If you feel comfortable with them, then continue. If you get a weird vibe from them, then just stop. There's plenty out there. They'll just show you what to do. Like I've had 10 or 11 vocal teachers.
Really?
Yeah, in my life, like starting from when I was a kid. So like, and each one will teach you something different. So it's worth it to check it out. And just don't worry if like they seem weird, like the vocal, not the teacher, the exercises that they teach you. Because
You'll see.
Cause like I actually do the vocal exercises that I do for singing before every grump session because talking for hours and hours is just as taxing on your voice as singing is. So I always feel weird because Susie, Aaron and Barry and Ross will be in the other room, and I'm like locked off in a room going like, like for like half an hour.
It's those ones that are the loudest.
When
you're just doing it's like whatever, but when you're like, it's like, oh, God.
Yeah, because what you're doing is you're training your vocal cords to, work effortlessly, let the sound come effortlessly. And to find out where the line of effort ends, you have to project as loud as you can.
Yeah.
So it just sounds awful. But when you're singing in a live setting in front of a bunch of people, you're like, oh, wow, this is much easier than I remembered it being.
Well.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So that's my advice.
Plus, it's like your voice is a muscle. Like, you have to keep working it out, like, constantly. Like, he or she also asked a question about improving flexibility and overall stamina,
mm-hmm.
and you just have to do it all the time. Like, when I was, like, really into practicing voice acting and stuff, everywhere, the shower, I'm making breakfast, I'm sitting down on my computer, I'm just talking to myself in different voices, and it'll just get better over time. You can't, I've never, like, worked on a voice. You just kind of do it, and then it develops into something cool.
Yeah, and for anyone who doesn't sing, I would also say sing. Just do it. Like, doesn't matter if you don't like the way you sound or anything. Like, when you sing, it releases endorphins into your brain, and you feel good. So do that. It's a natural high.
Plus, everybody will really like you at the karaoke.
Mm-hmm. Especially Asian people. Edit that out, please.
So there was a question that I didn't actually completely answer from Pac NB. It was, why don't I drink alcohol? The answer to that is because I've just never been a fan of not being in full control of my body, like in my mind. I've had a lot of bad experiences with other people and alcohol. There was one party I was at where some drunk dude threw a knife at a girl.
So whoa, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
So I was like, all right, I guess, you know, this isn't something I want to do. Plus, it's just the taste is nasty.
I got a feeling his problems probably ran deeper than just alcohol.
Definitely, yeah. But it honestly comes from, like, I'm a little bit afraid of myself. Like, I don't know what I would do if I was drunk. And I don't want to be violent, angry, or obnoxious. Like, those...
That's
and those seem to be the like, key result. There's nobody who's like, dude, I hate Steve, but when he drinks... Coolest
so
dude.
Cool.
Oh yeah. My God. Can we just keep him drunk all the time?
No, I had a different, like, we have different histories with that kind of thing. Like, I did some experimenting with drugs and stuff when I was younger, and I still drink wine occasionally, but not really at all these days. It was fun for the time, but now more or less the same. Like, I'd rather be in reality and rather, like, just relax, and I'm glad I got to a point in my life where I felt good without any help, you know?
Yeah. So that's the thing, is people are like, well, you just drink it to loosen up, and it's like, I've never had a problem loosening up.
I feel,
like,
loose. I'm loose as shit, man.
Loosey-goosey.
Yeah, so I guess that's the goal, really, to be happy no matter what. So if you don't need that stuff, why worry about it? Because it's expensive.
And it screws up your liver?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You are destroying yourself. That's the other problem.
That's probably the answer.
Cheers.
All right, Link to Legend asks, what would you suggest to get deeper into game design? Well, I honestly don't know, because they implied that I'm very good at dissecting game design, and I don't know that I am. It's all opinion. It really is. Like, whether you like a game or not is totally up to you. So I would suggest getting some books. The Art of Game Design is a good place to start. It's a very, like, vanilla kind of game design book by Jesse Schell. Reality is Broken is a good, philosophical book. Anything written by Ian Bogost. Play a lot of games. Watch a lot of talks. It was John Blow that really opened my mind to game design. Like, when he was like, you know, games can be more than just this thing that you're playing. And, like, a lot of the stuff that he said made sense to why I wasn't enjoying games as much as I did as a kid.
What is Tox? I don't know.
Tox at, like, cons or, like...
Oh, okay. Got it.
Conventions.
Oh, Tox.
Yeah, Talks.
Talks.
Talks. When they Florida. Go up on stage, you're and they from... go, bap, 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 bap.
Yeah.
Those.
I was like, I heard, like, T-O-C-H-S in my head. I was like, Tox. That's a gaming term.
Just a good old gaming noob. You're such a elite noob.
I'm a life noob.
So yeah, just try to articulate what you think is good about a game and listen to people talk about it and see if you agree with what they say. Because that was the real big thing. It's like, I wasn't enjoying games as much, and I thought it was just because I was getting older, but
it was because of the games I was playing. And I would like go back and play games from the era of the games that I liked, and I would still like them. And I was like, is that nostalgia or no? And then when I started, whatever. Read books, watch talks, play video games.
Books and talks.
T-O-C-H-S.
T-A-W-K-S.
Talks. Hey, Greenskeeper asks, have you heard from any of the developers that they've seen a sales boost from your playing the game?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, we have.
That's cool.
Mostly the indie games. I mean, if we played a big game from Nintendo from like 1985,
mm-hmm.
probably not going to hear from me.
Yeah.
But yeah, with the indie games, man, there's a huge, I think the Frozen Byte guys
mm-hmm.
at who made Trine, they
that was awesome.
And they
that
were
was
like,
awesome.
Dude, thanks for promoting the game. So.
Trine is an indie game?
It's considered one, yeah.
That's amazing. Yeah. That's an amazingly well-executed indie
right?
game.
Yeah, man. So we're gonna do everything we can to like keep supporting indie guys, because that's a lot of the reason why we brought on Steam Train was so that we could do more like PC indie games, because it felt a little out of place on Game Grumps, and we wanted like a PC outlet, because Ross is also a lot more passionate about PC games.
Yeah, that's Ross's bag, baby. And yeah, like we kind of feel like indie guys ourselves, you know, because we're in the entertainment industry technically, but we're not Hollywood, you know, we're do-it-yourself guys and like...
Speak for yourself, chum!
Sunglasses.
Yo, listen up, I'm in Hollywood! I'm gonna get...
Sick rap!
let me try one more.
Yeah, all right.
Yo, what's up, I'm in Hollywood! I'm gonna do what celebrities would! Don't you think that I should?
You could. Boo, 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 boo. Yeah. So we think that indie guys are awesome, and we relate to them a lot. So we love playing those games for sure.
Sick raps.
Vigrade. Vigrade asks, are you gonna play Pokemon X and Y?
Oh my god! It's so terrifying.
Yes!
Yeah.
Oh my god, I called up Game Plop and I was like...
Game Plop? That's the thing?
I called up Game Blob and I was like, when's the midnight release for Pokemon? And they were like, midnight, you dumbass.
Yeah.
No, they said they didn't have one. They said they open early, 1 hour early, which is
right.
BS.
Lame.
Because I'm up at midnight, but I'm not up at 9 a.m.
Right.
So... I know, right? It's weird. But, so, I'm gonna get it right away, and I'm gonna play it, and I'm gonna lose my mind.
Yeah, and we'll play it on Grumps.
We can't, though.
We can't?
We don't have a 3DS capture card.
Ah, sorry. But we'll play it in our own time, and we'll take pictures of ourselves enjoying it and upload them.
We should play it on Grumps.
Is there a way?
I can get a 3DS capture device.
Can you?
We would have to huddle over a tiny screen, though.
Fine.
Just like, we want to practice.
Yeah.
That Pokemon's weird.
I like these special times we share.
Do you like the keychain Pokemon? He's made out of keychains.
I like your hands. This took a weird turn. Let's cut this.
My Sario says, important!
Oh my god, all right.
How's your day going, guys?
Are you serious?
Yeah.
That's what it was?
Yeah.
Pretty sweet, man.
Yeah, it's really nice.
Thank you.
Hey, Goblin Kill Martin 922 says, Danny, where do you get the girls for your NSP videos?
Oh, well, at the beginning, for the first couple of years, it was just our friends. Actually, Julie Katz, the girl who's in The Decision, she was the one who introduced Ninja Brian and I to each other.
Wow.
Yeah. She's our mutual comedy friend. And so all the girls for, I'd say, the first 2 years were just our buddies. And then Lauren Francesca, we started working with her because we met her through the Key of Awesome somehow. And then we were like, oh, we should cast. Or she recommended that we start casting. So we started putting out casting notices, and shockingly, there were like a lot of responses.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we were like
on that list of like headshots with you.
It's amazing. Yeah. It's amazing, and because like, well, I think people understand at this point that like anytime we do a video, the only people who are gonna look stupid are myself and Ninja Brian. You know, like yeah. The girls are always like beautiful. So, but that's it. So like I guess the short answer is just like friends and then like casting websites and stuff like that.
When you put out like a casting call, is it like needed super hot girl for music video about my junk?
Yeah, I mean, well, yeah, because I mean, like, we say the band name, so already, like, they know something's ridiculous, and then we have links.
Do you make like sex like italicized and bold and like capitalized?
So yeah,
like, music video from Ninja sex party.
Yeah, agreed. And that's pretty much how it goes. And then like I guess
filming in my basement.
Well, that's the thing too.
Please bring no clothes.
Because the
wardrobe not required.
The views that we did not have at the beginning that we have now lend it like a credibility, so they know they're not walking into like a really weird situation.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's mostly it. Like it's pretty professional now, but at the beginning it was just like us going up to our friends who were kind of pretty, just be like, "You're pretty, would you be in a video?"
Kind of pretty.
Yeah, they're super pretty.
Burn.
Oh, I Julie, you're beautiful.
We got a question from Loudy.
Loudy?
Loudy.
Loudy, Loudy.
Loudy asks, what would you consider to be the absolute best moments of Game Grumps and Steam Train?
Oh, man. Oh, man.
Loudy, that's a good question. Loudy,
you wanna go first?
Best moments of Game Grumps and Steam Train. Well, recently, my favorite moment of Steam Train was when when Ross and I completed doing it the hard way.
That was good.
On V.
That was good.
That was like,
I liked it.
Because I'd never done it before. Like, I played and beat V, but I never did that one.
Right.
And, like, to do it for everyone to see and for it to just be like, oh my God! Because it was like a half hour of just trying it and trying it.
Very satisfying, I'm sure.
But, yeah.
I like Dennis the Menace the most. That's yeah, that's the one I
get out of here.
Get out of here.
That made me laugh like so.
Yeah.
Hysterics.
What are you doing here? It like that's the one I think I watch the most like in my own recreational time.
it's on my gotta watch today playlist. Yeah.
The Mickey Mousecapade
Morning
episode
jams.
Too.
Oh my God.
Yeah, just because like you lose your mind laughing like that so few times
oh God,
in your life.
Yeah.
And so to like actually
where you were making sounds.
Yeah, like I've like, never like I couldn't breathe. Like just being able to like listen to it and just being like, wow, that's what I sound like when
yeah.
I'm totally losing my shit.
What was the one sound you made when it finally like dropped? You were like
Yeah, yeah, I can't replicate it. I don't know how I did it. Those are my favorite moments. I think also like Super Mario 2, I think because that's when I first started like reading the comments and they were like very, very positive and I was
yeah.
like, oh, this is going to work. Like we're actually going to be okay.
Mm-hmm.
So that was a good feeling too.
That was nice. Yeah. Mickey Mousecapade was also one of those moments where like I realized that we could still be like super creative with the show. Because that was literally what was happening before we started the show.
Oh yeah,
like we were watching like a really bad playthrough of it, and I was just making fun of the guy, and then it was just like, why don't we just do that for the whole episode? And I was like, all right.
That's why I was like losing it like already, like as soon
yeah,
as you
yeah,
started
yeah,
the
right
episode.
Started, I was like Mickey Mouse.
Yeah.
Fucking Dan's just like ah.
Because I was already a giggle puss like for 10 minutes by that point.
I wish we could have gotten some of the early stuff on camera.
Yeah, it was more of the same. more of that.
Yeah. All right.
Cool.
Zach 091 asks, how did Aaron and Danny meet?
How did we meet? Go ahead, because I just drank boiling tea way too
cool.
fast.
Actually, you know what? Ross showed me Ninja Sex Party.
It was Ross?
Yeah.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Ross is responsible for all this?
He showed me Ninja Sex Party when you guys had like 9,000 subs.
Oh, like a year ago.
And I was like, why don't these guys get more hits? And then I sent you guys a message.
I remember it.
And then did you guys like not reply right away or like?
No. I remember it very clearly. We got a message. It was early on in our career, and we got a message from you saying, because it was buried in like all the weird messages from like, hey, why don't you join our crappy network, which is not even a network, it's just some guy in a basement. And you were like, you were super humble, and you were like, I've got an okay channel, I like what you guys do, if you want to check out what I do, go ahead. And you're like, hell yeah, man. And so we looked at it, and it had like 250 million somethings, and I was like, what? That can happen? Because we, like, Brian and I, we were like musicians and comedians, YouTube was kind of a foreign thing to us. We just wanted to make videos, and YouTube was like the venue that you put videos on. But we weren't really part of the community. We didn't know what was going on. So we had never heard of you. That is weird that you had heard of us, but not like vice versa. That's ridiculous.
No, it's fine. Better off for it, I'm sure.
I mean, it was funny too, because like it was a very flattering email, and I think you said like, if you're ever in LA, like just let me know. And I'll show you around. And normally I would be like, no, like we're not hanging out, but like there was something really cool about your letter. And like, I was just like, I just happened to be going to LA like, I think 2 weeks later. So
and then I picked you up.
Yeah, we went and got sushi together. And, and then like you dropped me off at my uncle's house and I was like, I made a new friend.
You had your backpack and everything.
Yeah, I did have a backpack. Yeah,
that was awesome.
Yeah, it was pretty.
and then dinosaur laser fight. That's that's what really kicked it off, I guess.
That's true. And then, although I would say that doing Game Grumps, like now it's like I feel more like you're like a brother, in a way, just because like Game Grumps, like you spend so much time together with the person, and also like. You're kind of laid bare as a person. You just say so much about your personal life that you get to know someone pretty quick. Yeah, right. I never had a real brother.
My brother would be so upset.
Oh, I'm sorry. I never had a brother.
He'd be like, oh, I'm your brother. Ugh. He's always like, why don't you do Game Grumps with me? Screw this guy.
Sorry, brah. He's my brother now.
So GC Rain asks, is there anyone?
Oh Jesus!
Sorry.
Oh my God! What happened?
Go on. I'm all emo now.
Is it?
We got emo and ego.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Hold on. Let me. Let's do this. Aaron and I do this thing sometimes when someone walks by and we act like guys in 80s movies who just saw a hot girl walk by, and we'll turn to each other like.
All right. So right. GC Ren asks, is there any one game you refuse to grump?
Oh, man. Not me. I'm cool with anything pretty much.
Really?
Yeah.
What if
there
was a game that was about sticking needles in your testes?
Is there a game like that?
Yeah, it's called Needle in the Testes.
That's not.
But
really?
it's in French, because it's a France.
French?
it's a French game.
So the
actual name is De Needle in the Testes.
Yeah. No, I'd play that.
Would you?
I'd play that.
All right, let's play it right now.
Okay.
All right.
How about you? Is there a game?
Rochambeau.
It's not a game.
That's a game? There are rules.
But I mean, like a grumpity game. Bump and jump? Is it bump and jump? Because I wanted to play it and you were like, no.
I do not refuse to grump bump and jump.
No?
No.
Okay. Yeah. We're going to get 1,000 requests to do it now. Yeah!
That game is a piece of junk.
It's terrible.
And it cheated on me.
What? With who?
Sorry. I was Stephen Thought. What?
who did Bump and Jump cheat on you with?
I don't know.
I'll kill him.
I just know that she cheated on me.
All right.
And I won't ever let it happen again. So if you're home, if you're out there Bump and Jump,
Hope that answered your question. Did it?
What? Mr. Raisin Toast.
Ah.
No relation to Cuba Toast.
Not Dr. Raisin Toast. Get your degree already.
Ms. Raisin Toast? She doesn't want you to know if she's married or not.
Do you have any plans for anything that could be considered big, such as
a special event?
Yes, we do.
We do.
We do. We do.
We do.
We very much do.
We so do.
It's called Starbomb.
Yeah. Don't say it out loud!
I'm gonna. We're trying to not give away too much about it, but it's coming out towards the end of November. It is a musical supergroup between Ninja Sex Party and Ego Raptor. And yeah, and it's we worked incredibly hard on it for months, and we're
months.
Yeah, literally days, and we're so
minutes.
We're so excited about it. But we want to keep it exciting and have it be a fun surprise for everybody.
So don't tell your friends, but maybe do too, because that would help us out as well.
Oh yeah, Starbomb.
Show the logo.
Show that logo, Barry.
I want a cookie. Asks.
Oh.
How do you guys not get sick of playing games all day? Especially if you've played them before.
Oh, that's not really a problem.
Would you? If your job was to play video games, would you get sick of it?
Would you? Yeah, well, whoops. I'll say, I spilled a bunch of water on myself. I'll say that most of the games we played are super fun. There was one day that we played like a bunch of awful ones like in a row, and it started to get to me. It was like Pinocchio, Radical Rex,
Maximum Carnage,
Super Alfred Chicken, and just like one after the other, and they all sucked. And by like the last one, like the episode starts, and I'm just like,
Was it Maximum Carnage where that happened?
I think it was Alfred Chicken. Yeah, and people are like, you were unfairly harsh on this game. And I'm like, I'm sorry, my rage had been building for like 5 hours.
Oh yeah, we got a lot of people that were like, no, Alfred Chicken's actually really good. And we're like, really good to yell at?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Really good at not being good.
It's a really good bashing your head on the ground simulator.
Oh yeah, 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 it does that. But yeah, like for the most part, like it's fun. It's super fun playing the games all the time. And even stuff I've played before, playing it with you is like a different experience because you're laughing at different things and noticing different stuff.
Also, it gets funnier when we get more and more tired.
Yeah.
Because we care less.
Yeah.
Like by the beginning of the day, we're like this. And by the end of the day, we're like this. And it was just like, look at that. It's stupid.
I like potatoes.
What's today?
What life is it? So
no,
yeah.
We don't get tired.
No, we're all right. No. So it's cool.
Never. Games are fun. Play games. Andre Almighty asks, how are you enjoying working with Polaris? How did the whole arrangement come to be anyway?
I don't know.
They suck.
The worst.
And how they're always so nice to us.
Yeah.
It really rubs me the wrong way.
It's gross how they let us use this couch and this room and all their camera equipment.
Always inviting us to like events with cool people.
Dick move, Polaris.
I got to meet Markiplier.
Mm.
He's such a nice guy.
We like Markiplier.
Really handsome.
That guy is a gentleman. And he's strong. He's got like strong arms. Mm.
Dude lied to me.
Wait, what?
Because I work out, but not very well. And I went up to him and I was like, hey, do you work out? And he was like, no, I'm just German.
That is a load of horse fudge.
And I was like,
fudge.
Go kill yourself.
Yeah.
And then later, the jacked dude from the Rayman tour, Burger Pal.
Oh, yeah, name, yeah, yeah, yeah.
He was super cool.
He was nice.
Not cool enough for me to remember how to pronounce his name, though. Wow, that seems super dicky. He was really cool.
Edit that out.
He was super awesome, and I really got along with him. And I was asking him about lifting weights and stuff, and then Markiplier was just like, yeah, you know, I do this, and I do that set and stuff, and I was like, you liar!
Yeah.
How dare you?
You made me believe that I could just think hard enough and sprout muscles out of my arms.
Or I could just be born in Germany.
Yeah.
And then that would work, too.
Did that answer your question about Polaris?
Colossal Fossil asks,
Don't make fun of him.
No, I'm not. It's a good.
Excuse me. He is a fan.
It was just.
He is a lovely.
He is lovely. I like fossils too. I like things that are of large size as well. It was the rhyme. It got me.
Colossal
made me laugh.
Fossil.
Colossal fossil. All
right. For as long as you've known him, has Barry always been that awesome?
Yes.
Yep.
Absolutely.
I can say without hesitation that Barry is one of the coolest, nicest, most awesome people in the world.
So helpful and accommodating and just like focused.
Yep.
Just hardworking.
Good person through and through. There will be no like flipping everything around joke at the end of this. Like, we honestly love Barry.
Barry's a man.
1,000,000%.
This company would crumble.
Yeah.
If not for Barry.
Yeah. And Susie. They're like the glue that holds everything together. Aaron, Ross, and I are like lost dogs that like can't even clothe or feed ourselves without those two.
We don't do anything.
We do nothing.
We play video games. We
bring nothing to the table.
These skills. Maybe some Oreos. I had some Oreos I was afraid it would get in my teeth. So I took some.
I was talking to somebody out there.
Right.
During our little break.
Yep.
And they were like, da 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 da, the words. And then, I mean, no offense to them. I didn't want it to. Talking about Kamen Rider figures or something. Now you know who I was talking to.
Yeah, of course.
I was just the whole time I was like taking water and like swishing it around. I was like, Yeah. Oh, yeah, definitely. It was really gross.
Right.
I apologize to you.
So Barry's cool.
Burnicle asks.
Burnicle.
I got a bunch of burnicles stuck on my foot.
Oh, this one's got a question.
It asks, have you ever gotten special treatment in public because of your YouTube channel?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I mean, more you.
Yeah.
More you than me. But recently, yeah, sure.
Thanks for the question.
No. Well, the first time I saw it really was when we went to see, what movie was it? Looper, I think? We went to see Looper and a bunch of people came up and just hugged you, like out of nowhere, like strangers.
Was that when they followed me out of the bathroom?
It was. It sure was. Yeah. That was cool. But
we love it when you guys do that.
Yeah, yeah. I love being cornered in a urinal by a man I don't know.
For me, it was recently. I was in Florida visiting my family, and we decided to go to the Wizarding World of Harry Potter.
Oh.
Oh, my. What a magical place that was.
And, like, the lines there were ridiculous because it's, like, brand new. And one of the attendants at the Dr. Seuss ride.
Awesome.
It was funny, too, because she was like, she didn't say that she recognized me or anything. I just walked up and she was like, are you guys trying to get on this ride? And we were like, yeah. And she was like, come with me. And then we were like, okay. And she like took us back and like through all this like dingy looking corridors and stuff. And I was like, I don't know what's going on here.
Yeah.
And she was like, you get on here. And I was like, okay. And she was like, by the way, I love your stuff. And I was like, okay, that's what's going on.
That's
very cool.
And she
was like, if you ever want to get on any of the rides today, I will radio you in and you will get right on.
Oh my God, that's awesome.
Like, I was like, I can't. And she was like, please, let me do it. Just let me do it. And I was like, maybe the Harry Potter ride? And she was like, done, go there right now. And I skipped like an hour and a half line to get on. It was amazing.
That's so cool.
Thank you. And Khan, you're awesome.
Yeah. I mean, usually it's at places you would expect, like GameStop and like other like places where our people hang out.
But GameStop is one of those places where it's like, I want to give you guys a discount, but we're so corporate.
Mm-hmm.
We just can't.
Yeah, yeah. I will be flayed alive.
I'll probably lose my job immediately.
Thanks for the thought, though, GameStop employees. We appreciate it.
You guys are great. Can I get Pokemon X and Y now?
Nope. I'll tell you right now, no. God, those shoes are awesome.
Oh, thanks, man.
Look at those Astro Boy shoes.
I know, right? These are my like prized possession. I almost bought two just so I could have one that's like clean.
One that you could dangle in front of my face and just be like, no.
Because they're like white.
Yeah.
So once they get dirty, it's just like, so.
I'm so jelly. So jelly beans.
You want me to get you a pair?
No, they don't make them in size 14.
Oh.
I know. Dude, I'm a monster. I'm a horrible monster.
Is that how big your feet are?
Yeah, check it out. Put them up. Put them up.
Oh, I got like dinky little tiny feet compared to you.
I belong in a circus.
I'm sorry, what was the question?
Yeah, I don't remember. We Are the Plague asks, what is your biggest musical inspiration? Everything. My favorite band is Rush. It's been my favorite band since I was like 13.
Give me a Rush mixtape.
Yeah, oh my god, of all my favorite Rush jams.
That's pretty baller.
Thanks, man. I'm so glad you liked it. It's they're my favorite, but like Pink Floyd was huge, Led Zeppelin, like a lot of classic rock. But as far as what I do now, I think like Lonely Island was a big influence in Flight of the Conchords. They kind of showed me that like comedy music could actually be like beautiful, good music, and Def Leppard actually. If you haven't heard the album Hysteria by Def Leppard, it's such 80s cheese, but it's like so passionately amazing and awesome. And it taught me a ton about like harmonies and everything. Queen also taught me a lot about harmonies. Dude. So yeah, those are my main ones. How about you, bruh?
I don't write music.
Cool.
Zombotic asks, what do you guys do to prepare for a recording session, and about how long do you record on average?
Prepare?
Prepare.
Eat a bunch of gross, sugary stuff.
I used to drink a Monster always. I stopped doing that, but...
Yeah, I like... I think I said it before. Skittles washed down with Pepsi. Oh, yeah. That's my jam.
A lot of water. Just screwing around.
Yeah, just laughing, and like you just get... Even if we're having like a bad day, like it just falls away as soon as like we sit down to grump.
Stretching and like wiggling is good.
Yeah,
it gets the blood flowing, and that's going into your brain.
Yeah, hopping around.
You're just kind of like your brain doesn't want to function either, so it's like.
Right.
What's a joke?
Sometimes I'll do that. You know,
You do that.
The little like let's do this. Just get yourself fired up.
And how long do we record on average? We do like...
Many hours.
We try to do like 20 episodes in a day.
Yeah. Usually it ends up being somewhere between 15 and 20, depending on like whether we run out of time or just burn out.
Yeah.
So that... And with breaks and food, like that, it's like... It can be pretty much
a whole day.
Yeah, it can be like 7 or 8 hours.
Like I get about maybe like 2 hours of free time afterwards and then I go to bed.
Yeah. Most of the time I'm just ready to like curl up into a ball. And like that's why we keep saying like we're gonna watch like Aliens and Wet a Hot American Summer and all these movies that we're like we have to watch. But like every time we grump by the end we're just like, let's just go into our separate houses and die.
And not watch movies together.
Yeah, yeah. Even like watching movies is like too exhausting for how tired we are at the end of them most of the time.
And it's like, didn't that part so cool? And it's like, what?
I'm sorry.
Part of my dream?
I like, what?
My dream was very vivid. It was about shooting aliens.
Shitting aliens?
Wow.
I thought that's what you said.
Took it in a bad direction.
I'm sorry. It's gotta be painful to pass an alien through your cold.
So this one's for you. From Uzi Oxix.
My favorite. What?
You try to say it, his name.
Where is it? Can you point it out to me?
Right here.
Oh. Uzi Oxix.
Uzi Oxix?
Uzi Oxix. UZIOXIX.
Way to make it normal, dude. What should we name our child? Clarice? Jordan? Or...
That third one, please.
I don't want to say it, though, because it might hurt.
Yeah. I forgot to read his question.
Hey, Danny. I'm cosplaying as you at Comic-Con this year.
That's awesome.
Any tips for that super sexy blue spandex sexy suit?
Oh, man. The spandex I bought as, like, a unitard. And then the cape is just, like, blue felt with white feathers around the edge, glued to the edge. And then red ribbon, like, glued or stapled on. I can't even remember. Just one for the necktie and little loops for the hands so the cape can come with you. And then the symbol is just colored felt that we cut out and like little pieces of Velcro that we taped on and just Velcroed it on. And now you know my secret.
I never knew how cheap your costume was.
Oh, it's so cheap. But the unitard itself was like, that was expensive. But to sex bangify it, very cheap.
It looks so great on camera.
Thanks,
and then,
man.
And then in person you walk in and
it's like yeah.
Is there a homeless man in my house?
Is there a homeless wrestler?
A scrawny retired homeless wrestler. Mm-hmm. Who didn't eat his greens.
It's true.
Or ate only greens.
Yeah. Yeah. I need more proteins.
I can get some proteins in you.
Whoa! Next question.
Hot juicy burgers. Asks. I just wanted to open it with.
Yeah, I didn't know. I thought you were just saying something.
Any games you have that you loved when you were younger but can't stand now?
Oh, man. Can't stand. That's so strong.
I know. It's like, ugh, get it out of here.
Yeah.
Like when somebody turns it on and you're like, yes, oh my God, I can't wait to play it. Yes. And then you're like,
yeah. You know what? My first system that I played games on was a Commodore 64, and that was by today's standards, extremely primitive. So like, I was very young when I was playing it, and I loved the games. And every time I've tried to play a Commodore 64 game since then, I'm like, really? Like, was that it? It's not that I hate it.
It was all happening in your imagination.
Yeah, that's exactly right. Yeah. That's exactly right. You look at those little like four blue squares, and you're like, that's a football team going across the field. So yeah, I think it's more a question of like things that I see that I'm like, wow, I'm amazed that I was ever really enthralled by that, as opposed to like hating, because like. If you loved the game in its time, that was its time. You know, like that's what it was made for. Like, no one builds a game like, oh, I hope people still love this in 30 years, because there's just no way of knowing that, I guess.
There are some people that build games like that.
There probably are.
More like timeless experience.
Mm-hmm.
I was trying to think the whole time you were talking, so I was not listening.
Right.
Is that okay with you?
Yeah, no, I mean, it's cool. You didn't even have to say it. I wouldn't have known.
Yeah, you're right. I regret it now.
It's okay.
The only one I can think of right now is Ocarina of Time.
Oh, wow. You don't like Ocarina, huh?
I used to really love it when I was a kid. Mm-hmm. And playing it recently is just really frustrating.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know. I guess, like you said, can't stand is kind of a strong
right.
term. But like, there's parts where I just get so angry with it because there's a lot of broken parts of it.
Yeah.
I'm trying to think of something that just like blew my mind how bad it was.
You know what I did really like when I was young? I liked Mickey Mousecapade a lot.
Really?
Yeah, I played it like, and I didn't get very far, but I did remember liking playing it, and like playing it now, it's just like, this really is terrible. It's so bad. It's not even like good bad.
When
you were
a kid, were you like, this game's a work of art. Yeah. Game's a Diarrhea Dookie masterpiece.
Don't even, please. I can't right now.
I went to the store and bought this game. When I got home, I got love.
Hey, Dan.
Hey, Aaron.
We got a question from Tepatty.
Tepatty, the moderator on the Game Grumps subreddit.
Woo!
Who we love.
He asks, how has the Game Grumps subreddit affected us?
Oh, man.
It's super awesome.
It's the best.
It's our hub for content because like we're a little indulgent. We like to like see all the fan stuff, like the animateds and remixes and stuff, and that's where it gets posted. Like everybody's sharing that crap around, and then everybody is so nice and they have like suggestions and like it's a cool place.
It's awesome. The moderators do an amazing job. Like you guys work, I feel as hard on that subreddit as we do on the show, and. You don't get paid for it, and you don't like get recognized as much as you deserve. So thank you for that.
Yeah. He also asked, "What do we think we could do to improve the Game Grumps subreddit?"
No.
Nothing. Like we don't want to interfere with you guys because it's a fan community, and when we post on there, we're kind of posting as fans. Like we don't want to be viewed as like moderators or like the bosses or anything like. Because it's really up to you what you guys post and stuff. We don't want to police you.
Yeah, we kind of, like I was talking about before, like when when we record the episodes, it's just you and me on the couch. But then once they're out there, it's kind of like for everyone, you know? So like we just, when we're posting on the subreddit, it just kind of feels like we're just like people.
Yeah.
Like
we just kind of show up and we're like, hey guys.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You
yeah.
want a milkshake?
You want to go to the malt shop? Two
want,
straws.
Want some seltzer water?
So yeah, thanks Tay Patty, and thank you Zandan and Sliforia. I can't remember all the mods
there's
names.
There's a lot of mods now.
Yeah, there's a lot.
I can't keep track.
But we love you all. Thank you.
You guys are great. I'm not Sonic. I'm Blonic.
Writes.
You sounded like Yukino Joe.
Yeah, that's his.
Oh,
that's his cartoon.
I've seen it. I love him.
He writes, did Barry really beat that Mario Sunshine Pachinko stage in one try?
He did.
Yes.
He absolutely did. That is 100% true. We struggled with that for the better part of like 2 hours, lost our minds, and then Barry, we were like, Barry, can you please just take care of this? He was like, all right. Did it. It's like nothing.
Oh my god.
He didn't even break a sweat.
I remember that moment too. I was like, get that. Oh my god.
It was hilarious.
Am I? Is that visual?
Yeah.
Can you see that?
Well.
Because it was intentional.
I can feel it. It's like a mist.
I wanted to be like a saliva volcano.
It's very disgusting.
A saliva-cano.
Spit-cano.
Spit-cano.
I think that was our last question, but I just want to say. That there was another question, I don't know who it was from, but they wanted to know what product I use in my hair, and I just wanted to say that this is pure Judaism. There's nothing in here but Jew, baby, and like,
ow!
Yeah, whatever.
I was gonna say,
yeah, whatever you do to it, it just does that. Oh,
that's awesome.
Yeah,
I
thanks.
Do that, and mine just goes back to being perfect.
Yeah. What a nightmare. So just wanted to answer that before we go.
I use Suave. Shampoo and conditioner.
Oh, all in one.
It's a dollar.
Saving time.
Actually, with the economy the way it is, it's actually $1.20.
Let's cut this.
Thank you for coming to our Game Grumps AMA. Dan. Dan, how do you feel about how it went today?
Super good. Totally. Skittles. Thank you.
I'm not laughing, I'm crying. I'm crying so. Ow! Ow! Not your super move! Double quarter circle forward, two punches!
Oh man, thank you very much, everybody. That was super fun. We had a good time.
I did too.
I had a good.
Yeah, don't.
Ow!
Rubber bands are not.
Ow, rubber bands.
They're not the best.
Ow! Oh, now I look good. Now I look ready for a night on the town.
You look like Misty.
Who's Misty?
From Pokemon.
Oh, from Pokemon. I thought you meant like, yeah. No, I. Thank you.
Nice save.
First of all.
Oh, from Pokemon.
Oh, of course. Right, I know Misty. Right, right. I know Misty.
Can we change the subject real quick yeah. so we don't have to keep talking
Misty,
about it?
Misty from Goku.
Goodbye, my friends. Until another hour of another day, of another week, of another month, of another year, of another century, of another millennia.
Of another eon, of another...
All right, I think millennia was as far as we needed to go. We will be together again. On this stage.
Another...
With you answering, asking the questions, and us answering.
Error. Another error. High five. Bye.
You're a dick.